Hello everybody, I'm Nathan9062 and welcome back to Nemesis. So, if you haven't seen the last episode, go ahead and see it because you'll have no idea where I got this or this. So, you should go see that episode, otherwise you're going to be like completely off sync to whatever's going on here. But if I can actually stop opening my inventory and make some actual progress here, I can actually show you what we're about to do. So, we're going to go back through here. I know, it seems like a very bad idea because Nemesis was there, which again, you need to see the last episode because, seriously, what are you doing? You need to see the last episode or else you're going to be confused for what's happening in this episode. So, I need to use these gems for this clock thing here. So, I need to put these two gems in and then the clock will work. And then everything will be joyful. See that? We'll open and we can go through it now. Yay, passageway. Nemesis like ran towards me. But luckily he doesn't have the skills I do. Alright. So I think now we've avoided Nemesis for now. I didn't itch on my leg to scratch, okay? Alright. I think we'll go this way. I'm not so sure there's anything else the other way we actually need. So, this way there goes the car. Oh. Hello. Okay, come on, please. Thank you. Anyway, there's the cable car, which introduces us to the rest of the mercenaries. And yeah, that's already spoiling too much if you haven't seen this game all the way throughout yet. Alright, there's two herbs there, but I have the space, I can use it. Dog here. I think I should back up and then killing stuff is fun. Only in virtuality though. Don't actually go out and kill people the more you know. Ooh, 14 ammo. Okay. That was a lot. That's like doubled it was before it was with 7. Alright. What you got? Well, I know what you got, but whatever.
One of the survivors from the rescue team, right? I just ran into your teammate, Carlos.
How did a girl like you manage to survive?
Sexist.
Hey, I'm no ordinary civvy. I'm a member of STARS.
STARS? You mean the RPD Special Force Team? Ugh.
Hey, is someone wounded back there?
No, this is Patrick.
This looks bad.
They're coming. Get ready. Fire. Fire. Stay together.
Calm down. You're safe now. Everything is gonna be okay.
No, it's not. There's more cutscenes coming, so I'm just gonna be quiet. So, yeah.
So, Jill, did you decide to help us out? It looks like we're the only ones who survived. We should work together.
No, we can't trust her.
Why? But, Sergeant, we need her help. Our unit's down to you, me, and Lieutenant Mikhail. That's it. And Mikhail's hurt bad. If we don't cooperate, we won't be walking away from this mission.
Then let's go over our plan. We're moving to the clock tower area, which is the designated landing zone for the extraction chopper. Once we get there and give the signal, the chopper will fly in and pull us out.
That's a lot of ground to cover. I don't think we can make it on foot.
The main problem we have is that the landing zone is cut off from here by the fire. So we have no choice but to use this cable car to navigate through it. Fortunately, we can also use it as a moving shield to get us through the worst areas.
That works for me. Good plan, sir.
Okay, people, let's get moving.
Jill, put this on.
It's more close to cover up your skirt. Just kidding, it's more inventory space. See? Look, now we're up to 10. And we need what looks like a butter knife here, but it's actually a wrench. Okay. So, now our mission is to get the cable car working and go to the extraction point so we can get out of here. Which is Jill's, like, original intention in the first place. But it works out. Oh, there's more dogs. Well, luckily this is where Resident Evil 3 AI, so they're kind of dumb. Look at them. Look at them go. Any day now. Just kidding. You're too dumb. I'm just insulting all these zombies, and they are probably good boys. They are probably good boys and good lads. But, except the hunters. The hunters were born through a pregnancy via Satan. That's how bad hunters are. Like, seriously, you do not know my struggle with hunters and my pure hatred for them. That actually genuinely got me. I forgot that was gonna happen. Oh man. This is some things you can't stop laughing about. Laughing causes choking, which can be fatal. Oh no. I remember this part though. Oh no, I don't. Okay. Just kidding. Oh my god, I'm remembering all the wrong stuff here. Yo, did I just get four? I got three headshots in a row. That's actually awesome. Oh my god. I got three headshots in a row. Oh my god, that's actually sick. Oh my god. I'll push the button. It's holding something in its hand. It's a bronze book. Ew. Anyway. Let's go. I cannot... Wow. I got three headshots all at once. That's actually amazing. I think the Desert Eagle also increased your chances for critical hits. So, and by critical hits, I mean, like, the higher the chance it is for you to blow a zombie's head off. That's what I mean by critical hit. Although it doesn't do anything against hunters, because you're stupid. Alright. So, let's go back and end the episode. So, we have an entire, like, mission set to do. And, unfortunately, I'm out of time for recording today. So, time to do what we do best. End the episode and save our game. There's our ink ribbon right there. Alright, so anyway, thank you all so much for watching. If you liked what you saw and you want to see more, go ahead and show your support down below. And I will see you guys all later. Bye bye.